Hey everybody, it's Holly here, and today I'm going to be using the Avery Elle Oh What Fun stamp set, and I'm going to be using the Lawn Fawn of Boca in the Snow 6x6 paper pad. And we're going to start out by stamping the Santa image onto a piece of Nina Solar White cardstock using some Tuxedo black ink from Memento. And I've actually been using the Nina Solar White cardstock for my Copic coloring for a while. But lately when I've been using it, I've been having a lot of trouble with bleeding, so I'm not really sure what that's about. So I think I'm going to switch to a different cardstock. I do like the Copic Express It cardstock. It's just not as bright white, so it kind of depends on what you're going to use it for. And this stamp is new, so I'm conditioning it by stamping it once onto a piece of scrap paper, because that will help ensure you get a solid image when you stamp it again. So we're going to go ahead and color that in with the Copic markers. And I'll go ahead and, this is such a small image, I'll just play a short little bit of music while that's playing, and then I'll be right back, okay?
Hippopotamus for Christmas. Only a hippopotamus will do. Don't want a doll, no dinky tinker toy. I want a hippopotamus to play with and enjoy. I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. I don't think Santa Claus will mind you. He won't have to use our dirty chimney flue. Just bring him through the front door. Thank you.
to go ahead and fussy cut the image out with my scissors. This does have a coordinating die, but I just did it with my scissors. It's so simple and little. So I'm going to go ahead and color in the outside edges to hide some of the white from the cardstock with the black marker from Memento, the Tuxedo Black. And you just take it around the edges. It just gives you a nice clean look. And if you have any jagged edges when you're fussy cutting, it just helps it look more even. And of course, you can always use the coordinating dies as well. So while I was coloring, some of my red bled into the beard and some of the white parts. So I decided to try to cover it up a little bit with some of the Copic white, opaque white paint. It does work sometimes, but it's only going to work in a really small area because you can't go back over the Copic white paint with your marker. It won't pick it up. So you can see there, I put the white on some spaces where the gray was to give the shading, and it just stood out too much. So I didn't, in the end, I didn't really like it. So I did find kind of a remedy around it. I went ahead and on the bottom parts of his coat and his sleeves and the part of top of his boots, I added some clear wink of Stella later on, and that helped mask that area. But with the beard, wasn't happening. I didn't like it. So you will get to that here in a little bit. So I'm using the stitched wonky dies from Avery Elle for the frame, and then I'm using the Lawn Fawn stitched hillside border dies to create my snow. And then I'm using the Lawn Fawn, I'm not sure what that die is. It's the one to cut out all the trees. I'll put a link to it in the description box below. But the stitched hillside die and that die like match up together. So I'm just lining those up and using, here I'm just using some temporary adhesive on it to get that die onto it. So I cut the piece of the bokeh cardstock to fit into the die. And I'm going to glue down the trees with the first hillside. And then temporarily here, the front one, because I'm going to pop that up with dimensionals. I go ahead and run that through my Big Shot, and I ran it through twice to make sure I really got a good impression with the die. So here I'm going to go ahead and add some that foam adhesive to the back of that first hillside. And that's just going to help pop it up. And I'm going to go ahead and create a A2 standard size top folding white card base. And then I'm going to glue that panel down to the front of that. And then for my Santa, here's where I can show you. I decided to make a second head for the Santa, or a face. And I got the idea to use an action wobbler to try to cover that up. So here I'm cutting the action wobbler, trimming it down to fit. I did edit out the first action wobbler that I cut. This is the second one, actually. It was not fun to cut these things. They're actually hard plastic, so you need to have a really good pair of sharp scissors to try to do it with. You want to use your old, like, rubber cutting scissors. And then I couldn't get the action wobbler to stick. It was not fun. You can see here I'm frustrated. So anyway, I did finally get the new face over top of the action wobbler to cover up that first one, because I just didn't like how that Copic paint was showing up on the beard. So I'm going to go ahead and add a little bit of dimension to the back of the Santa. And then I glue his body down directly onto the card. Then I took my white gel pen and I added a little bit of snow to that tree border in the background, because it is snowing, so Santa can't eat snowflakes and there not be snow on the trees. Then I just took the white gel pen and added a couple dots along his tongue and a little bit on his face. And then I'm just gluing the body down onto the card. And then for the sentiment, I'm stamping "Oh What Fun" onto a scrap piece of the white cardstock. I'm just using the Tuxedo Black Memento ink. And then I'm just going to trim it out into a little strip, and then I'm just going to make a little banner end on the end of it. And I'm going to add another strip of dimensional adhesive to it and pop that up there at the top. This is actually a pretty easy card except for that action wobbler. So thanks for watching and I'll see you guys soon.